Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you how to use Copilot in Microsoft Excel. More specifically, I want to show you the potential of using Copilot in Excel. If you're new to Excel, and maybe you don't know how to create formulas or add charts, work with pivot tables, do conditional formatting, all you have to do is ask Copilot to do these things for you. You can either type it in or just use the microphone to talk it in. Let's get started on how to use Copilot in Excel for beginners. Now, Copilot isn't something free. This is something you do have to add with a subscription. You do need a Microsoft 365 subscription, and then you need to add Copilot Pro to this. Now, once you add Copilot Pro, this is going to be not only in Excel, but it will be through your other Microsoft 365 products as well. This is the sample data that I'm going to be using to show you how Copilot works today. If you want to follow along and you have Copilot, you can download this. Just look down below in the description, and then you can follow along with each step. The first thing that I want to show you is if we go up to the ribbon and we have Copilot right here, notice that it's grayed out. That's because this file is saved on my computer. Copilot doesn't work if the file is local on your computer. You need to upload it to OneDrive. And so what I'm going to do with this file that I have open, I can do this in a few different ways. I could just click right up here and hit upload. Or I could go to the file and I could go save as, and notice I can go to OneDrive or to the SharePoint, because at that point it's going to be uploaded. So I'm just going to go and choose OneDrive and save it here. Now that this file is saved in OneDrive, notice that we have Copilot and I can click on it at this point to open up the side panel. I can resize this so this gets a little bit larger at this point. And you have a few more options here where you can move, resize, close as well. Now take a look at the options that I can't do because it's grayed out. That's because Copilot still needs something else. It needs to turn this data over here into a table. Now I could go and insert table up here or do Control T, but right here we have convert. Copilot's going to do this for me. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on convert. And just like that, it converted all that range into a table. And notice now I have all these available to me, which we'll dive into in a moment. As soon as this turned to a table, if you wanted to do any reformatting, it's quick to do it with any of these and all your options of filtering or sorting up top. Now that's probably why they turn this into table, because it makes Copilot much easier to work with when this is in a table format. This down here is the prompt area. This is where you're going to ask Copilot to perform tasks based on this data over here. Now you may be unsure what to ask it if you're brand new to this. There's suggestions here. If we go view prompts, you'll be able to see that it gives you some ideas what you might want to ask. Now they have different topics that you can go through. Is it for creating? Is it for understanding? It will help you kind of get your prompts off the ground. The other thing I want to point out, use your microphone. Just talk and ask it a question. You can always undo the prompt that you created or whatever it performs, and then it's going to just help you understand how to create a good prompt for Copilot to do exactly what you want. Now, what I like to start with is these up here. Let me give you an idea. So if I click on highlight, it will tell me what this can do for you. Now, down here, this is where it will perform a certain action. Do I want it to bold the first column? Do I want to show items with the sales date? So if I go and click on bold the first column, it's going to go through this data and just bold it. So it will format for me. So let's go ahead and click on it. So if we take a look at this column over here now, we can see that it formatted it with bold. As I mentioned before, we have the undo here. Now, the other thing I want to point out, whenever you see the refresh besides here, if I go and click on it, it will give me different ideas based on the data, what it might think that I want. Let's go back up and try something else. Let's go add formulas and columns. So now it tells me what it's suggesting what it can do. And we have add a column that combines product and units sold. Well, maybe I don't want that. So I'm going to go ahead and just hit refresh. Now it's giving me three more options, and I can still go ahead and hit refresh again. Notice that it's saying show total sales revenue by sales date as a line chart. It will even create a chart, and I haven't even had to prompt anything. Actually, let's go ahead and try this one. It's done, and it created a line chart that shows the total sales revenue by sales date. And here it is. So all I have to do is click add as a new sheet, which I'll do now. And we have the data that it pulled out here and created the line chart. I can still go through and do some formatting it if I want, but you can see how they have the pivot chart field over here that it created from the data. And I haven't even asked it to do anything yet. It was just suggesting things that I might want to do. Now, if I go back to sheet one here, this is where I'm going to see Copilot again, but I can go back and forth between the different sheets. These options up here to learn are great, and it's a great place to start. But let's move down to the prompt area and ask it a number of questions to perform on the data. Let's start with this. You know, I noticed that there's a time in here and I don't really want the time. Let's see if I can ask Copilot to remove this. So I'm going to say remove time from the sale date column. Let's go ahead and send this. Now, if I take a look at the sale date, it is fixed. The time is removed. Let's go ahead and ask it to pull out some numbers. You know what I'm really curious about? What product has the most units sold? That's kind of probably an obvious question that people would want to know. Let's go and send that. It looks like the winner is widget B with a total of 563 units, and it went ahead and created the pivot table for me. If I move up a little bit, here it is. I can add this to a new sheet. Just like I showed you before, we have our pivot table here. Now I'm just going to move back to sheet one, and I want to know something else. And these first few are pretty simple questions that I'm asking, but I'm kind of curious of what is the total revenue. Let's go and use our microphone for this one and just go ahead and ask it this question. What's the total revenue? So I sent that away. And again, we have our total, we have a pivot table that we can add to the sheet just like before. Now, let's see if we can add a new column. So I want a new column created, and it's going to be called sales tax here. So we'll just do one step at a time for this one. So we'll create a column named sales tax. Let's go and send that. Take a look at this. I asked it to create a column named sales tax, and it said, here's a formula column to review and insert. I didn't even tell it to do the formula yet, and at 5%, I was going to get them to do it, but it already jumped ahead and created a formula for me. If I like this after the review, and I can even go and take a look at the explanation of it, I can go ahead and hover over insert. Notice as I hover, it shows where it's going to go and the amounts. Now, I could go ahead and make an adjustment after. Do I want this added to the total sales revenue, or do I want it to be just by itself as that 5%? I'm just going to leave it as this, as separate, just 5% out. I'll hit insert. Now I have that new column. Let's see if we can make a little bit more complex formula here when we add a new column. This is what I want to have happen this time. I want to add a new column called discount. And it's going to look at the units sold, and if they see it, if it's above six, so you can tell that there's going to be an if statement in here. If it's above six, it's going to give a 7% discount. And let's go ahead and add this to our prompt. Let's see what happens here. So create a new column, name discount, give a 7% discount if units sold are over six. I'm going to go ahead and send this. So here's the formula to check. I can see it has the if statement in here, but right away I'm noticing, you know what? There's something I did this wrong. I asked it the wrong question, because if I hover over it, notice it's just going to give 0% or 7%. I actually want it to be applied, the discount. So I want to multiply the 7% by the sales revenue. So I have to change the question a little bit. So I'm just going to go down here and put this one in. So create a new column named discount, give a 7% discount applied to the sales revenue if units sold are over six. So the main thing what I want to point out is just go ahead, notice if you make a mistake, just go and tweak the prompt and then get it back to what you wanted. Let's go and send this one. So this one's looking a little bit better. I can see in the if statement here, so it's going to look And this is the part that was missing in the first one. It was the sales revenue times the 0.7% or give back zero. Let's hover over it. So now it's giving me amounts for this, and that's what I want. Now I could go another step forward and maybe add this to the sales revenue, but I want it separated out. I'm going to go ahead and click insert. Now I have that column here with that formula attached to it. At the beginning, we created a chart. It was a line chart based on these learning options and how Copilot took us to there. But we can go ahead and ask it to create a chart on something specific. So if I say create a bar chart showing each product total sales. So if I go ahead and send this, now let's go ahead and just move up. We should have our bar chart here, and we have our widgets right through here, and they place them in the order of the best sales, of the top sales on it. And I can add this to a new sheet like we did before. And we have the pivot table and charts all connected to these. And remember, you can do formatting on it just like you can do in Excel, like I've shown in other videos. If I move back here, let's go and try a pie chart this time, create a pie chart showing each product sales of the total, and we'll send this one. Let's move up a bit here, and we should get a pie chart showing each of these. And I can go ahead and add this new to the new sheet just like I did before. Let's finish up with this tutorial about talking about some formatting options again that we can do with Copilot. Let's try a few different formatting options. And the first thing I notice is that, you know, these columns here probably should have the dollar format here. So I think I see there's probably units, price, sales, revenue. So there's four that should have it. Let's go ahead, and I could ask it to do a specific column. So I could say unit sold, unit price. But what happens if I ask it use dollar format in the proper columns? Will it know? Let's go ahead and send this. Now it looks like it missed one of the columns. I can see it found sales revenue, sales tax, and discount, added the dollars, but it didn't add it to the unit price. But I think that's going to be a quick fix. I'm just going to go ahead and ask it, add the format to unit price as well. And I'll hit send. And there it made the change. Since I'm in the same thread, it knew what I asked up here, and then it just added that formatting to it. Let's try one thing more with formatting. And this time we're going to be looking at conditional formatting. Now, I want to be able to look at this over here, and if anything's below 7, I want it to be highlighted in red, and if it's above 10, I want it to be in green. So I'm going to go ahead and ask this, highlight in green, units sold, above 10, and highlight in red, any below 7. Let's see if it knows how to do this. And this looks pretty accurate over here. We have our red if it was under 7 and green if it was above 10. So that's a handy way just to go ahead and ask it to do those formattings with whether it be typing or using the microphone. I hope you found this video about Copilot in Excel helpful, understanding the potential behind it. That being said, I think it's still important to understand the basics of Microsoft Excel, at least when you're using Copilot. It's going to really help you with your prompts and looking at the data and understanding what's happening. If you're interested in learning about more Copilot applications in other Microsoft 365 products, I'll put a link to my video for that up above in the card. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.